So welcome to the second lecture of your digital electronics of SOP and POS form. We had seen the two inputs in that particular lecture, previous lecture, whatever we had. And now we will go for the three input part. So I will just quickly share the screen with you so that you can go through it very well. Hope the screen is visible. So now we are going to solve it for three inputs. Of the system. The three inputs of the system we are taking as A, B, and C. This particular system will have three inputs, and the three inputs will be A, B, and C. So as you can see that if we are going for SOP form means what it is again, I'm repeating it. SOP is sum of products. Means whatever the three combinations are possible for product of this, first will be A into B, second will be B into C, and third will be A into C. These are the three possibilities, A into B, B into C, and A into C. And now this product has been completed. Now I will do the sum of it. So A into B plus B into C plus A into C. This is the only possible combination for three inputs, right? If I am taking two at a time. So I will see how we are going to do it by this particular example. You can see the example which is displayed on your screens, right? So we are going to see the example and then see how it is going on like, right? So the example says for the function of A, B, and C, we are having three functions, function A, B, and C, which is written as A bar B plus B bar C. Here A bar and B are having a product and B bar and C is having a product and we are having a sum of it. So that is why it is in the SOP form. Sum of products. These are the two products. A bar B is one product and B bar C is the second product. So that is why I am having the sum of these two products. So this is my SOP form. But this is not my standard SOP form. Standard SOP form means what? Standard SOP form means it will have all the variables, variable A, B, and C. Standard SOP in each and every term should have all the three variables. So you can see here, if I write it again, this particular part A bar B, this particular part A bar B is not having any C term, right? And this particular part B bar C is not having any A term, right? So we are saying that this is not the standard SOP form because this first is not having any C term and second part is not having any A term. So I need to make it converted into the standard SOP form. Now how I am going to do that? For that, I have some Boolean laws to be taken into consideration. What are the Boolean laws? We have the Boolean law A plus A bar is equal to 1. This is one Boolean law which we are going to use. A plus A bar is equal to 1. Similarly, B plus B bar is equal to 1. C plus C bar is equal to 1. I am just writing here for A. A plus A bar is equal to 1. And here I have this particular demonstration of that. This means what? If your A is equal to 0. If A is equal to 0, then A bar will be? What will be your A bar? Then A bar will be equal to 1. Right? Here I am using this, for example, A plus A bar means 0 plus 1. 0, A is 0, A bar is 1. 0 plus 1, you get 1, right? Again, if you take the opposite of this, means if you take A is equal to 1 and A bar is equal to 0, A is 1 means A bar will become 0. If you take the opposite of it, then also you get 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. Means both these conditions are getting satisfied by this Boolean law. A plus A bar is equal to 1. So I'm going to use this in the further equation. We'll use equation number 1. See equation number 1. Function of A, B and C is equal to A bar B plus B bar C. This is given in the question, right? So we are going to see the same question here. What we can do in that? Now I told you this 41st part is not having any C in it, right? This first particular part is not having any C term. So what I will do, I will simply multiply here 1. Similarly, this part is also not having any A. I will multiply 1. I have multiplied 1 to both the sides, right? Now this 1 I will write in this form. Whatever is not there, I will write this 1 in this form, this Boolean law form. and I will see what is not there. So what was not there in the previous one? What was not there in the previous one? This particular term does not have C. So one will be written in the form of C, C plus C bar, this one, right? I'm writing here one as C plus C bar. And in this particular term, I'm not having any A, right? So I will write this one as A plus A bar. This one is C plus C bar, and this one is A plus A bar, right? So simply just multiply this A bar B inside bracket and B bar C inside bracket. Just multiply it. What will happen? This A bar B multiplied by C, we get A bar B into C, right? And this second part will become plus A bar B into C bar. Multiply this A bar B into C and A bar B into C bar. You get these two terms, A bar B, C, and A bar B, C bar. Similarly, open this bracket also. What you get? B bar C into A and B bar C into A bar. B bar C into A gives you B bar C, A, and B bar C, A bar. These are the four terms which I get, and with this plus sign in between. So I have one product. This is my second product. This is my third product. And this is my fourth product, right? Four products, and what I'm doing? I'm doing the sum of them. I'm doing addition of these products. Plus, here also I'm adding it. Here also I'm adding it. So now, these terms become my min terms. These terms are called as my min terms. And you can see that all the terms are having the three inputs. ABC, 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 right? So now this form can be said that it is my standard form. This form is my standard form of what? The expression which was given to me, this expression. This expression has now been converted to the standard form in the main forms, right? Now here you can see that I have written it in the form of, see here, I have written it in the form of this part is M1, this part is M2. This part is M3. I have not written M4. I am writing this part as M5. So you might think, where is M4 and where is M0, right? So I will tell you where it is. I will tell you why I have taken only 1, 2, 3 and 5. Not 4 and 0 is not taken here. First, we will see that SOP is written as what? It is written in the form of sigma, right? So write it in the form of sigma. So function of ABC will become sigma small m. And what are the min terms? I have 1, 2, 3 and 5. We are not using 0 and 4 here. We are not using 0 and 4 here, right? Why we are not using? We'll see in the next slide. Up till this, just to see that we are writing this in the form of standard SOP form. This is your standard SOP form of this equation. And this equation can also be written in this form. This equation can also be written in these two forms, M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M5. And this is written as summation of M1. This M1 becomes 1, 2, 3 and 5. Clear? Now we will see why we have omitted this 0 and 4 terms. 0 and 4 term I have not taken. Why it is so? We will see in the next slide. Right? So I'll move on to the next slide. So for three inputs, what are the things which I have into consideration now? See, for three inputs, what I have is, I will write the decimal equivalent. What are the decimal equivalents? See, we are having 2 raised to 3. 3, why? Because 3 is the number of inputs here. 3 is the number of inputs here, and the input is, what is the output I am getting here? 2 raised to 3, it is 8, right? So that is why I am getting here 2 raised to 3 as 8. So sum of products means I am writing this truth table for this particular form. So the sum of products of the truth table is like this. 8 we are having. So we will take count till 8 numbers. Starting from 0, 8 numbers means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Then we are considering 0 to 7. This gives me total how many numbers? 8 numbers. Right? So this is why I'm using this 8. Decimal equivalent I have written from 0 to 7. Now again, we will write it in the form of Boolean. We have three inputs A, B and C. Write it. For three inputs, we will have 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Right? Then we will have 0, 0, 0, 110011. And for C, we will have 010101. This you all know, right? Now what I am going to do is, I am going to write it in the sum of product forms. Means what I need to do, I need to do the product first. So simply, what consideration we take here? We consider 0 is equal to whatever your input is there, bar of it, and 1 is equal to without bar, right? Use this consideration here. For 0, 0, 0, what we have? A bar, B bar, C bar, right? Then for 0, 0, 1, what we have? A bar, 0 means A bar, this 0 means B bar, this 1, it becomes C, not bar, because we for 1, we do not use bar. Then for next input, what we have? 2 is what? 0, 1, 0. 0 will be A bar, 1 will be B, and 0 will be C bar. Then 0, 1, 1. For 0, 1, 1, what we have? 0, 1, 1. 0 is A bar, this is B, this is C. Then for 1, 0, 0. 1 will be A, 0 will be B bar, and this 0 will be C bar. So what I get? A, B bar, C bar here, right? Similarly, for the next one, what we have? 1, 0, 1. 1 will be A, this will be B bar, right? This will be your B bar, and this will be your C. What I have? A, B bar, C, right? Then we have what? 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0 means A, this is your B, right? This is your B, and this is your C bar. So A, B, C bar. And last one, this will be your 1, 1, 1 means A, B, and C. No bar is there. So this will be A, B, C. Clear? So depending on this, I will write these outputs as M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, right? For example, I have the output as this. I'm having output as this. This is my output table if I get, for example, right? So for this output, if I have this kind of output, what are the terms where I have a high output as shown by this arrow? Here I am having one, 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 here I am having one. Simply note down the high outputs. What are the high outputs? This A bar, B, C bar. Then next is A, B bar, C bar. Then next is A, B bar, C. Then next is A, B, C bar. And last is A, B, C. And what are the terms for that? M2, M4, M5, M6, and M7. These are the products which I have. Now, next step is what? Sum of it. Next, we need to do the sum of it. So, how will we do in doing the sum of it? See here, down. So, I will write the high output terms here in the form of sum. Only the high outputs I'm going to take. The high outputs I'm taking as this M2 here. This is M2. Then I have M4. Then this is M5. Then this is M6. This is M7. Right? So now you can see this is which form? This is my standard or canonical form because it is having all the three values in all the three terms. A, B, C. We are having three variables in all the terms. So this is which form? This form is called as the standard SOP form or canonical form, right? So here, what were the terms I used? Here the terms which I used was, I used the term here as M2, which had only the high outputs. I am taking the outputs which were only high. M2, M4, M5, M6, and M7. Now you might understand why we have omitted here 1 and what I have omitted, 1 is not taken. 3 is not taken, 0 is not taken, right? So these three were not taken. Why? Because their output was low. Their output was low. They had a low output. So that is why I selected only the outputs with the high output. And I made the sum of it, right? Because 0 added to any number will give you the same number. So you will remove the low outputs. Only high outputs will be taken. M2, M4, M5, M6, and M7. And these M2, M4, M5, M6 and M7 were represented by in the form of ABC like this. M2 is this, M4 is this, M5 is this, M6 is this, and M7 is this. This is from the truth table, I have seen already, right? So again, this equation, equation number 1, can be minimized as, I am minimizing this equation now. This equation I am minimizing, okay? How I can minimize that? How I can minimize that? First term will be same. Write it here in this equation, right? I have A bar, B, C bar, right? Next term, in these two terms, what is common? I have A, B bar common. Here also I have A, B bar common. Take A, B bar common. What is remaining here? C bar plus this term is C, right? So from these two terms, I have taken A, B bar common. Now what is common in these two? Here A, B is common. A, B take common. What you are left with? C bar plus C, right? So this here I have taken this common, C bar plus C is remaining. So what I have done, I have just changed this equation number 1 into this. Now I have this particular law I have seen in the previous class, that A bar plus A is equal to 1. This is the Boolean law which we are using. Use that Boolean law, put it there. So we will just put the Boolean law over there. What does it give to me? Just replace this C plus C bar by 1. Replacing this C plus C bar is by 1. So what I get? A bar B C. This is same, right? Then A B bar is there. Replacing this by 1. Then AB I have as it is. And C bar C is replaced by 1 again. Okay? So this is the representation in this one form. Now what is, again solve it again. What you have here? A bar B C is same. In these two terms, what I have, A is common. Here A is common. Take A common outside. What is remaining here? B bar. And what is remaining here? B is remaining. So write it here, B bar plus B. Again use this law. B bar plus B will become 1. Right? So using that law again, so what it becomes? A bar B C bar is same. Here A is same and here B plus B bar is 1, right? So I have reduced it. I have used this law. B plus B bar is equal to 1, right? Now I will use distributive law. What does distributive law tell me? See, what is distributive law telling me? Simply distribute this particular thing. This is also next law. For this, you need all that particular laws to be well known to you. Distributive law says, if I have A plus A bar into any variable B, see clearly, A plus A bar into B is equal to A plus B. This is written by distributive law as A plus B. This A plus A bar gets converted into A and plus B is remaining, okay? So I am changing this B variable by X. I am taking it as X. I will just tell you why I have taken it as X, because X I am taking as BC bar in this equation. This particular BC bar I am replacing by X. Remaining is same, A bar is there, A bar, and here A is there, A. Okay, only this BC is replaced by X. So using this law, what I have? Using this law, I will have this equal to A plus X, right? Because here it was A plus B, so it will become A plus X. And X was what? B plus C bar. This is your minimal form. Right? So we had two forms. First was the standard SOP form, in which all the three variables were there. This was your standard SOP form, where we had A, B, C, all the three variables, right? And then we had the minimal form, where I have only this short form of this particular equation was there, that was converted. Now you understood why in the previous slide, why in the previous question I did not use this. So that is why in this particular case we did not have here in this particular case, the previous problem which we had seen, we did not have here M0 and M4 because they were the low terms, right? And how I converted this? I converted this from the truth table. In the truth table you can see, I will show you again, A bar BC, what is this in the truth table? We will see. See the truth table. What is this in the truth table? A bar BC in the truth table. A bar BC is what? your M1. So that is why I have replaced it by M1 here. Understood? So this is the form in which we are going to convert the min terms into your max terms, whatever we are using. Clear? So this is our SOP form. Now we will go for the product of sums form. Product of sums form tells me what? It is the opposite of your sum of products. It is simply the opposite of your sum of products. So again, we will draw the truth table for that. This happened in the previous form we had drawn. We will draw it again. So for the three inputs, what we have? 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Again, here for the variable B will be 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. For C will have 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. This is the input we have got, right? Now what we need to do? Product of sums. Product of sums. So simply do the sum of it. Decimal equivalent also I have written here. This is for 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We are having 8 because 3 variable 2 raised to 3 is 8. So that is why from 0 to 7, 8 variables we are having, right? I have written the min terms also. This was in the SOP previous table. This table we have already seen. Now we will see this table for max. Max terms. Max terms is what? Sum we are doing. Here we did what? We did the product. Here we will do the sum. So simply first will be, now for POS, consideration is this one. For POS, consideration is this one. 0 means A, 1 means A bar. Remember, 0 means A, 1 means A bar. Opposite of SOP it is. Okay? So use it. Do the sum. First is, first input is 0, 0, 0. Means, 0 means A. Okay? So this will be A, this 0 will be B, this 0 will be C. So we have A plus B plus C. Right? Similarly, do the other ones. 0, 0, 1. 0, 0 means A plus B. 1 will become C bar. So A plus B plus 1. This 1 is in bar form. So that is why it will become C bar. So that is why A plus B plus C bar. Next one will be A, B bar, C. C. A, B bar, C. Addition. Then A plus B bar plus C bar. C. A, B bar plus C bar. Then we have A bar, B plus C. A bar plus B plus C. Then this is A bar, B, C bar. A bar, B, C bar. Then is A bar, B bar, C. A bar plus B bar plus C. This is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. A bar plus B bar plus C bar. So this is how we are writing it in the form of sum. Now what we need to do the? We need to write it in the form of capital M. M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. So these are the max terms for what? For your POS term. These are the max terms. In SOP, we had min terms. This is max term. This is small m. This is capital M. The convergence considerations taken for SOP are this. Considerations taken for POS are this. Opposite of it, right? So this is how we are going to convert it into now the POS form we have, right? So the POS form, we'll just see a short example how it is. Now we are doing product of sum. Product of sum. We will have sum. We will do the product of it. Okay. Do the product of it. We have function F, A, B, C. This is one sum. This is one sum. A bar plus B bar. Sum is there. Right. And B plus C. This is also sum. And what we are doing? We are doing the product of it. So this is in which form? This is in the POS. Product of sums. These are two sums. And this is the product of it. Right. So we are having it in the POS form. Again, if you see this POS form, in this part, we are not having what? We are not having C. And in this part, what we are not having? We are not having A. Right? So we can say that this is not the standard POS form. This is not the standard POS form. Standard POS form, if for C, standard POS form, here all the three terms should be there. Here all the three terms should be there. So we need to convert it. In previous SOP, what we used? We used A plus A bar. We used A plus A bar as what is equal to 1 we were using. We were using A plus A bar is equal to 1. A plus A bar is equal to 1. This I was using in SOP. So for POS, what I'm going to do? For POS, I will use A dot A bar is equal to 0. This is for POS, opposite of it. Okay. So just use this. We will use A into A bar is equal to 0. This we are using for POS. We can verify this also. If A is 0, A bar will become 1. Answer is 0. If A is 1, A bar is 0. Answer is again 0. So this is for A is equal to 0. This is for A is equal to 1. Right? Using this fact, we will see what is further it is saying. So we have seen that in our particular question, in this part, C was missing. In this part, A was missing. So simply adjust it like this. If I write this equation, equation number 1 in this form. If I write equation number 1 in this form, is there any change? No. What I'm doing, I'm just adding a 0 here. And here also I'm adding a 0. Addition of 0 does not make any change. So I'm just adding 0. Now this 0, I will replace with the term which is missing. C into C bar. Right? Using this particular law. A dot A bar is equal to 0. Here also B and C was there. A was not there. So I will write A into A bar. I'm replacing this 0 by this. Right? Here also I'm replacing this 0 by this. Okay? Now just open the brackets for what you have. Whatever answer you are getting, see, open the bracket. If you do this by distributive law, we are again using distributive law. If it is in the form of multiplication, it will once be added with this, once be added with C dash. So we will have A bar plus B bar plus C. Right? And then we will have what? Then we will have A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Okay, distributive law. So we have these two things. Again, here also, first we will have B plus C plus A, then B plus C plus A bar. These are the two terms which I have, right? Now you can see that in these four terms, I have all ABC, 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 ABC. Now you can say that it has been converted into your standard POS form, product of sums form. So this is your standard POS form. Again, from the table, you can see, from the truth table, you can see that this term is what? This is your M0. This term is what? Your particular M4. So this has been replaced by this particular term. So these are the higher terms which you are having. This you will be writing in the form of low terms wherever you get 0. Okay? So that is why what were the omitted terms here that you need to take? M0, M4, M2, M5, M7. What is M0? What is M0 from the table? Previous table we'll see. What is M0? A plus B plus C. What is M0? A plus B plus C. I will see whether this is there or not in that particular case. Just see. A plus B plus C. Do we have this term? A plus B plus C? Yes, we have it. Where is this term? A plus B plus C is here. Right? So this is your A plus B plus C taken as M0, right? Similarly, you can find out all the other terms. What are there? What are the other terms we have? M4, M2, M5, M7, M6. M2, A, B bar, C. A, B bar, C. Is there A, B bar, C? So this is how you can find out that whether you are having these terms or not. And then you can write it in this particular form, in the form of pi. Similarly, what you need to do is you just need to write it in the form of pi. Clear, all of you?